We can move on to the next speaker, who is Hans Dirk.
Dirks, okay. Yes, thank you.
Okay, so sorry for my pronunciation.
It's
okay. Okay, perfect. So you have already shared your screen. So the next talk will be given by Professor Hans Dirk, and he will talk about the title of his talk will be Mathematical Description of Linear Core Rotors in Terms of Phase Defect Lines. So please, the floor is yours.
Well, thank you. And also thank you to the organizers in general for hosting a wonderful virtual meeting. So my talk is in fact also about the topology of cardiac activation patterns. And you could see this, I believe, as an alternative to the previous talk. Instead of the contours, we will work with phase defect lines, trying to make sense of the patterns which we see on the heart. This is work together with my group in Kortrijk at KU Leuven and also with Alena Tolkacheva from Minneapolis. So this is a slide we've seen before. It was created by Flavio Fenton, and it shows that complexity of cardiac rhythms is related to the complexity of the underlying patterns. But the reason we do this work is because the exact patterns during heart rhythm disorders are not yet fully understood. So there is some modeling and analysis needed to tie the experimental and clinical side to each other. In this talk, I will revisit basic topology of patterns. If I say revisit, I should also mention the classical viewpoint. So the classical viewpoint was also briefly described by Noah in the previous talk. So what one does is if you see a pattern, for example, on the cardiac surface or in a simulation, you can pick two variables, V and R, and plot them against each other. And then you take the angle in this plane, in the so-called phase plane, and you call this the phase. And if you apply this to a surface or a pattern, you can see that it is nicely colored according to phase. And in some points, it seems that all phases are touching each other. And this is called a phase singularity. So if we review the classical theory, then it has some assumption in it. Because we know that if you go around the circle of a spiral, around the center of a spiral, the angle changes over 2π. But then this last step is in fact an assumption, because there is more than one possibility. It is not necessary that if you have a phase difference of 2π, that there is a phase singularity inside. And this is the point I want to make here. But still, if we assume that there is this phase singularity is there, then the classical topology is very simple. You can have like a wavefront, which is joining all points with a given phase phi1. A wave back is joining all points with phi2. And then if the two of them match, they match in a phase singularity where all phases are reached. And this is an example from Gray, Pertsov, and Khalife. And this is a more recent result by Gurevich and Grigoriev, in which you can also see the contours that were discussed by the last speaker. However, the reason we want to propose something different is that there are still some issues related to classical phase singularity mapping, as shown here. So if you have this classical S1, S2 protocol and you create a second wave in the wake of the first wave, then you can see that this wave is blocked, which is given by this black line here, and that two spirals are being formed. But still, if you apply a phase detection algorithm, a phase singularity detection algorithm, it does not find yet the singularities here. But if then the waves collide, it can detect a whole number, maybe 5 or 6 phase singularities here. But this exact number will depend on the algorithm which you use. So this is with like a 2x2 stencil, and this is with a 4x4 stencil. So something is going on here if you look or if you use phase singularity detection close to a conduction block line. Another example is given here in the Fenton-Karman numerical model. So you have a linear core rotor, which means that this spiral wave is traveling around its own refractory tail. And then you can see that besides the phase singularity, which is located here, there is also a line of conduction block, but this line of conduction block is not captured by the phase picture. You can only see it if you look to local activation times. If you use this LAT map, you can see that isochrones collide and that there's a conduction block line here. And a third example of a relation between phase singularities and conduction block lines is given here. This is an optical mapping recording of ventricular tachycardia in rabbit hearts. And here you can see that the detected phase singularities are all present on conduction block lines. And also you can see that you have a single conduction block line, which is like the core of this rotor, because the wavefront is circling here in time and it's moving around this conduction block line. But you can see that multiple of these phase singularities are present at this conduction block line. So you can think like, is it normal? Because we would expect that this is single rotor, but we can find between 1 and 5 to 6 phase singularities here. So what is going on there? So to have an example or to look into, I take this classical picture because something is going on at this conduction block line. Basically, if you start a wave like this and you let it propagate, then you see that the wave tip cannot enter the refractory tissue. That means that across this conduction block line, the phase to the right is different from the phase to the left, because this part of the tissue was activated recently and this one was activated earlier in time. Therefore, phi A is not equal to phi B. That means that there is some structure here which is characterizing a phase surface which is close to this continuous. So I mean, here is the phase is one value here and one value there, and this transition is known in physics as a phase defect line. In mathematics, it's called a branch cut from complex analysis. And we argue here that the structure that is seen as in conduction block lines in the heart is more close to a line defect than a point defect of the phase. You can then also ask, is the wavefront also a phase defect? Well, that depends on the definition of the phase, because the phase definition that we showed before is not a unique one. If you have the classical activation phase using this polar angle, you can color a spiral wave like this, and then you see that there is, let's say, a phase defect with a region of abruptly changing phase close to the conduction line, block line, and to the wavefront. However, you can also define arrival time phase. That means you assign the same phase to points which were activated at the same time, such that the resting state has phase zero, and after full evolution, fully recovered state has activation phase 2 pi. And if you color the same wave like this, then you see that only the conduction block line is a region of discontinuous phase. So this brings us to a complex analysis viewpoint on cardiac arrhythmias. If you have a model with circular core, then everything is fine, I believe. Because for a circular core, like in Aliyev-Panfilov model, you can see that there is a phase singularity there, and it looks like a staircase surface. And the staircase surface is also known in mathematics as a phase singularity. However, if you have a linear core, for example, in Fenton-Karma model or Lou-Rodi, Bueno-Orovio, and so on, then you can see that there is this conduction block line. And this conduction block line shows or is a place where the phase surface is torn, where it is discontinuous. And therefore, if you want to use a complex analysis, as is often done in phase analysis of the cardiac activation patterns, I think we should allow that not only simple phase singularities, but also these extended line defects can take place. So we have one paper on the review, which is accessible here. And this same ID was also recently coined by a Japanese group, and you can see the reference here. So if we look to the landscape of cardiac activation patterns, it looks like this. In the classical picture, if a wavefront hits a wave back, then the two should join in a phase singularity, so a pair of opposite phase singularities are formed. However, if you also track the regions of this continuous phase, then you would see that there is a region here, which is a conduction block line or a former conduction block line. And then we call this a phase defect line. If you do the same to a linear core rotor, then this is the classical picture. And we suggest to replace it by this thing. So the wave front and the wave back, they have different phase, but they can also be joined by this phase defect line. What does it mean for the landscape? I mean, in classical, let's say ablation therapy and so on, the landscape is flat. There is just phase is behaving nicely. And at some points you have singularities and you're looking for some points in the landscape and you want to ablate or target these. If you move to the alternative viewpoint, then we see that phase is discontinuous along extended lines. So it's more like a cliff landscape. So here we see that the interpretation of cardiac activation patterns could be more like you have hills and at some points you have cliffs which in which the phase or here the altitude is significantly discontinuous. We applied it to simulations and here you can then see that the classical wave front and wave back, they join in the white dot, which is the phase singularity, but the conduction block line is also a phase defect line. And therefore the cliff, which I talked about, would be located here. If you use this alternative phase definition using arrival time, you can also see that it's almost zero everywhere except in this conduction block line. And this can also explain, for example, if you look here, if you apply a normal phase singularity detection, it is sometimes here at the interface between the wave back and the conduction block line. It can be here, it can be here, it can give multiple phase singularities. And then the main message is like, it's normal that there should be multiple phase singularities because these detection algorithms are not trained to take into account that there is a cliff. They're just looking for isolated singularities. And therefore they are not so well behaved as we would like them to be. We also tried this in experiments. So in the optical mapping experiments, you can also track these phase defect lines, which are nothing else but conduction block lines, either as a normal conduction block line or at the core of a rotor. And then you can see that these phase singularities, we think they are in fact artifacts of the detection method and they emerge and go away. They can jump around on this conduction block line because in the case where the rotor has not a circular core, but a linear core, that it is not the fundamental structure that we are after. We can also show some statistics. So this is for six different experiments. We find that the fraction of phase singularities that lie never on a phase defect line is below 1%. So I would say, and there is still noise and experimental error, that nearly all phase singularities are lying on this phase defect line or on a conduction block line. Also, we can see that these phase defect lines, about two-thirds of them do not host phase singularities. That would mean that they are just conduction block lines, and the one-third that hosts the phase singularities would then be the centers of rotors. A second thing to see is here the mean lifespan of the phase singularities is about 3 frames or 3 milliseconds, whereas if you would track these phase defect lines, they live for on average 15 milliseconds. So it means that they are longer lived and more robust structures in these experiments. So my conclusions are the following. We know that excitation pattern analysis has been based on phase singularities for decades. However, at the conduction block lines, there are phase defect lines and current theory and data analysis do not take them into account. So this leads, for example, to non-robustness of these phase singularity locations. Our observation also explains why the phase singularities and conduction block lines coincide. This was also reported by others also in clinical studies. And a main take-home message is that the phase singularity is a simplifying concept, but in some cases it may be too simplifying and something else may be needed. So that's all I wanted to say for my talk. So thank you. I will also put some advertisement here. We have two open positions at KU Leuven for professors. So if you're an interested postdoc, you can save these links and visit them and apply. So thank you for your attention, and I will be happy to answer questions.
So thank you very much, Professor Dirks, for this very interesting talk. I will just add a quick comment. I think that your approach would be also very, very interesting to use in contexts where you have high heterogeneity of the tissue, and maybe there finding these kind of functional lines will be useful. And so they will appear functional lines, and with your method, you will be able to track them.
I think so, yes. They could be either like spontaneously, but probably in the heart there's a lot of heterogeneity, and it will be tied to this heterogeneity. So you can also try to derive the heterogeneity from the block lines and vice versa.
Exactly. And so there is a question from Noam et al.
Yeah, hi Hans. Thanks for the really interesting talk as a very cool alternative representation. But I was wondering if how would you go about sort of differentiating between like a true line defect and just sort of under-resolved spatial data? So I'm wondering, in some of these systems, I'm wondering if it's just sort of like very fast fronts.
I don't follow this remark from very fast fronts, but I would say like if you're... You could say that the phase singularity is the limit of a phase defect line with length zero. So if your spatial resolution with which you are viewing, for example, in intracardiac patient recordings, then you cannot go beyond this resolution to see if it's a phase singularity or a phase defect line. And that's why for now we are also using like the very high resolved data, such as simulations and optical mapping. But I think if you do, let's say, the calculation or from action potential duration and conduction velocity, that you could more or less find in the medium whether it should be a line defect or a point defect.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Welcome.
So we have time for other questions. So just to add a comment on the last question, I think that in order to have a point singularity, you need to have a situation where you don't end up with head-tail interactions. And otherwise, as it was shown here, you will end up with the line. Mm-hmm. So. And I think that in the cardiac tissues, it is likely to find this type of head-tail interactions, or they appear very often, I think.
Yes, I mean, from the moment we thought about it and we started looking into data, we also have data from optogenetics in cell cultures. Then we see these linear cores, as you would call them, as one would call them. But if you just look at them and analyze it, then we have to conclude that they are not the classical phase singularities. So we hope that some of the questions about these phase singularities and, for example, why rotors are short-lived and so on, that they could be get an answer using this formalism.
Okay, so I have a question about the data that you have. So they, how did you acquire them and in which condition?
The data, these data are from optical mapping by our collaborator, Elena Tolkacheva. I think you should look to her paper, the references in our archive paper to see what it is. So it's basically Langendorf perfused and illuminated from both sides and recorded from two sides.
Okay. So thank you very much. I think that if there are no additional questions, seems not, we can move to the last